What is the third eye? How to awaken your third eye? Param Shanti. This is a conversation between Anant Bhai and Bapuji. Anant asks, Bapuji, I wish to know about the third eye. What is the third eye? People the world over have their own notions of what exactly it is. It can be overwhelming and difficult to understand. Could you please explain in layman's terms as to what exactly the third eye is and what is its significance? Can human beings activate it or not? Bapuji says that a lot of people have their own perceptions about the third eye. Lord Shiva has a third eye. When I go into yoga or samadhi state, I am in soul consciousness state, so I'll share my personal experience firsthand. I've personally experienced for many, many years that when the third eye is open, one has divine vision. The third eye really is the state of soul consciousness, just as it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Since Gita is the greatest of all holy scriptures and there is nothing beyond that, Lord Krishna was an avatar of Supreme Almighty Authority. God says in the Gita, become soul conscious and remember the Supreme Soul. The stage of soul consciousness is referred to as the third eye. When you have the third eye open, all your issues are taken care of. You can do whatever you wish. Lord Shankar or Shiva could do anything with his third eye, right? He could see the entire solar system. Whatever you wish to see, you will be able to see. When your third eye is open, you can even read other people's thoughts. You can also influence their mind and change their destiny. But how can a family man go about it? There are so many ways, like Tratak technique, Kriya Yoga, etc. However, I wouldn't go into those details now. To awaken the third eye is to remain in soul consciousness state. Bhagavad Gita speaks of a thoughtless state of equanimity, Sthita Prajna, which is the soul consciousness state. Gita is the jewel in the crown amongst our scriptures, and Lord Krishna was the avatar of the Almighty Authority, so the knowledge in the Gita was given by the Almighty. But people try to awaken their Kundalini to open their third eye blindfold and practice all kinds of techniques. People do a lot of hard work and they try various methods, but that is not going to lead them anywhere. Saints and yogis perform severe penance for eons without ever succeeding in achieving the third eye, in activating the third eye. Show me any holy scripture or historical book that gives examples of anyone opening their third eye. Men go and meditate in mountains, trying to awaken their Kundalini, but nothing really happens. Third eye is the soul itself. The word Atma or soul was used for the first time by Krishna. The essence of the Gita is to be in soul consciousness state. That is the message in the Gita. To know the Supreme Soul, you first have to know who you are. You need to know who you are, where you are from, what you want to do, what the purpose of your life is. Is life's purpose just to eat, drink and be merry? Now, for the children who want to attain soul consciousness, let me give them a method, lest I should forget. To be in soul consciousness, you can use a gross light source, white light, similar to the practice of Tratak that people do with the morning sun. Sit in front of the light source, close your eyes and visualize the light in your forehead, between the eyebrows, the spot where we do Tilak. Keep stating that you are a soul. You will gradually experience soul consciousness. Your soul is in your midbrain. This is what runs your body and your mind. First, understand where the soul is. Many seekers have misconceptions of where the soul is located. Some say it is in the heart. Some say it is in the mind. Some say the mind is in the heart. I have already stated in many videos that the mind, intellect and personality traits are inside the soul. Your personality traits are determined by your thoughts and actions. That you are a soul is common knowledge now, but to attain soul consciousness, I sit in several poses. Since 1991, I've been experiencing soul consciousness. Spent hours practicing without food for 24 hours, with just a few sips of water. I sometimes sit in a chair, and I can remain in soul consciousness with my two eyes open. I can do it even while I'm eating or sleeping, because I've been doing it for years. I've been doing it since 1991. And that is the reason why from 1997, I've been able to download this much information. I have done a lot of meditation for this. I mean a lot. On Sundays, I used to do it for 24 hours without eating or drinking anything. Maybe a few sips of water. Then the body and mind become light. Then to emerge your soul consciousness will take less time. So the technique is this. Keep a white light bulb in front of you. Close your eyes and try to focus on the light in between your two eyebrows, like they do in the Thratak technique. And then keep telling yourself and all through your day that you are a soul. Until you gain soul consciousness, you will not receive any power of the Supreme Soul, no matter how much you try. Realize that you are a soul first, as the Gita says. Become soul conscious and think of the Supreme Soul. When you do that, you slowly begin to emerge the realization. This will take a long time, as this is not an ordinary feat. You know, they offer services to open the third eye. You have to stay with them for 6 months or so in their ashram, and they charge large sums of money. They try very hard to open the third eye. I have studied the four Vedas, 16 Upanishads, 18 Purans, but I have never met or heard of any sage that have their third eye open. Ananth, if anything, most of those people could only see the future, like in the book of Paramahamsa Yogananda, the autobiography of a yogi. It mentions that some sages and saints could levitate, some could appear to be in two places at the same time. These things that Yogananda witnessed is written in his autobiography, and crores of people have read the book. People want to be able to do these type of miracles. Bapuji, they did Kriya Yoga and they do talk a lot about miracles. I have said in many videos that miracles cannot be done by ordinary people. No one has understood the knowledge in Bhagavad Gita. The people that do miracles have assistance from souls in the subtle world. When someone does Yoga Nidra, these souls hover around the individual because they know that they can get power by being close to the individual, and they do steal the power from that individual. I have said this before in many of my previous videos. Anand says, Bapuji, these clairvoyants can see what someone is doing in America or distant places, and they are able to see the future. Bapuji says, you know how these are people that are able to drive and do various things while completely blindfolded. You've seen such things, right? Anand says, yes, I have. Bapuji, they can even read stuff blindfolded. What happens in these cases is discussed in previous videos, is that these superhuman feats are done with the help of entities from the subtle world. They do it to make an individual famous. Anand, so what you are trying to say is that the third eye and these unusual feats are completely different. Bapuji says they are different. Third eye means to realize yourself. What purpose does it serve to know about others? If you do miracles, would the world change for the better? Anand, what good is it if we can levitate? Does that help anyone? Bapuji says, 50 or so souls in the subtle world can come together and pick you up to make it seem that you are levitating. Some magicians are able to do that right now. They do magic. Is that short of a miracle? Isn't there a magician in America that levitates and floats on water? What's his name? Anand says, There are so many things happening around the world that is beyond the understanding of science. Let's leave those things alone and focus on reality. Bapuji, leave these things alone. Don't get drawn into this. What we have is an ocean of knowledge. Watch all our videos and then they'll understand how much knowledge is available here. Anand, people go after superhuman abilities. Bapuji, but what will you do with these superhuman powers? Would these powers help you to achieve self-realization and get you to the supreme abode? With these powers, you may be able to levitate. Then, would you be able to levitate to the supreme abode? Vishwamitra meditated for thousands of years and he could not reach heaven with the body. So don't bother with these things as they are just worthless. You focus on the soul and the supreme soul. What you are is a soul. So you just focus on remaining in soul consciousness. I've explained the technique many times. Use the white light technique. The soul is a very minute, subtle dot. You may do it sitting down or you can do it while sleeping as well. This yoga is very gentle. It is to realize yourself by being in thoughtless awareness. In the thoughtless awareness stage, you will have the experience of soul consciousness and then you think of the Supreme Soul in the Supreme Abode. Take power directly from the Supreme Soul, who is the Almighty Authority. Understand who is the Almighty Authority. It's not the infinite solar systems. Infinite solar systems make a galaxy, and there are infinite galaxies that form a universe, and infinite universes make up a great, great universe, and so on. We have a lot of videos on these. You have to know who the Almighty Authority is. The first subject is knowledge. Anand asks, you mean the third eye is divine knowledge? And with that knowledge, you can merge the soul consciousness with the supreme consciousness? Bapuji responds, I'll tell you the procedure that I have followed. Leading my life as a family man and running an income tax lawyer practice, I've practiced to remain in soul consciousness. Day and night I have practiced. It took me several years. And leading my life in that manner gave me so many good experiences that my life transformed from worldly to divine. Being in soul consciousness gives you so much confidence that you can do whatever you want because everything is already recorded in your soul. This cannot be done by any ordinary soul. I have talked about the various categories of souls. Third quality souls, third class souls cannot achieve this. Only the souls of the infinite realm Behad, souls of high quality, will be able to emerge this knowledge and they will practice to be in soul consciousness. First, they will learn about who they are and who the Almighty Authority is. They will not bother with Shiva or Mahashiva. They will directly seek out the Almighty Authority. They will look at the vastness of the world based on science and scriptures. They'll try to understand infinite solar systems, galaxies, universes, multiverses, and think that the world may be bigger than that as the creation is infinite. The Supreme Soul is not something commonplace. It is the Almighty Authority. The first step to become soul conscious and it will take, the first step is to become soul conscious and it will take a long time for the souls of the infinite to make progress. I have done a lot of hard work, lived the life of a Karma Yogi, as recommended in the Gita. You shouldn't forsake your worldly duties and responsibilities and run to the forest like Gautam Buddha, who left his wife and a young child, or like Mahavira, who left his wife and child. You shouldn't run away from your responsibilities. It is written in the Bhagavad Gita that your grihasthashram or life as a householder is the greatest. When you are stuck at home, handling your karma, you should remain in soul consciousness. As you realize it, your third eye will be awakened and you will have divine vision. Anant asks, once an individual becomes soul conscious, would that person be connected to the infinite cosmos? Bapuji says, very good question. When you attain soul consciousness, the records that are inside the soul will open. If the soul is born of this solar system, then the individual will see this solar system. If they are from the galaxy, that is, if they are the category of Mahashiv, then they will see the entire galaxy. They will see the infinite solar systems within it. If they are of the universe, they will see the whole universe and so on for the multiverse, great universe, great great universe and beyond. If the person is a soul of the infinite realm, that realm will be visible gradually. Anand says, that is great information. Bapuji, because it is recorded in their soul, I am telling you from personal experience. I am not telling you something that I have read from some book. It's not written in any book. They talk about opening their third eye through Tratak technique. Here we are talking about the soul consciousness. When Lord Krishna, the Almighty Authority, gave the knowledge of the soul and the Supreme Soul, there is nothing beyond that. The essence of all scriptures and Vedas are summarized in two words, Atma and Paramatma, the soul and the Supreme Soul. You are a soul. Realize that you are a soul. When the soul awakens, your subtle body, causal body, supra-causal body, and the supreme causal bodies will get awakened. With that, you should spread vibrations of supreme peace all day long. I've said this in many videos. Spread vibration of supreme peace. Keep saying, Behat ki param param mahashanti hai. With those vibrations, your home will become a temple. The atmosphere will become pure. Even your neighbors will begin to feel peace. Supreme peace is the road to bliss. Anant. This means that when the soul connects with the Supreme Soul, the third eye will become active and we will get the divine vision and the records in our soul will start to emerge. They become like the Supreme Soul and they realize who they really are. Bapuji, let me tell you this. Sages try to awaken their kundalini and they meditate for thousands of years. They open their seven chakras first and then the sahasrara. When the soul is realized, there is so much light within the soul, it has supreme light if the particular soul is made of supreme light. If they are not made of the supreme light, then they will not be able to do it. I am only talking about the special souls that are of high quality and made of supreme light. When you become soul conscious, the Sahasrara will open and you will be fine-tuned like an antenna or dish to receive divine vision, to see the solar system, galaxy, universe, etc. Your aura will become so powerful and whatever you desire, you will be able to manifest. But by then, you will start to stop thinking. Then the only thought within you will be that of world transformation, just like me. I had this goal even when I was little, when I learned the techniques to transform. Through self-transformation, you can contribute towards world transformation. Bapuji says, yes. With soul realization, the entire record of where your soul originated from will open up to you. Anand says, this information, Bapuji, is really valuable, that if the Atma is of this limited realm, it can only see the limited world. If it belongs to the Behad, it can see Behad ka Brahmand. What the soul will be able to see will depend on the place of its origin. When you talked about creation of the soul, you mentioned that souls can originate from various planes. In creation, like our solar system, galaxy, universe, multiverse, etc. And there are souls of the infinite realm that are stuck here and are trying to wake up to go back and get liberated from this world. Wherever that soul can find knowledge, it seeks it out. It's looking for answers to who am I, where have I come from, how can we change the world. To learn that opening the third eye is removing ignorance through experiential knowledge, through soul consciousness, was an eye-opening experience. The goal of the soul is seeking the right knowledge to attain divine vision, to connect to the Supreme Soul, to receive power from it, and eventually become like the Supreme Soul. Bapuji, Yes, take power directly from the Almighty Authority, the highest powerhouse. It is referred to as the Gyan Yoga of the Infinite, Behad. If you have knowledge of the Infinite, only then will your union with the Infinite be successful. Also, you have to be a soul of the Infinite Realm to achieve this. This is not for ordinary souls. Anant infers, we can now say that all the miracles that we hear about of levitation, clairvoyance, appearance in many places simultaneously, not being visible in the camera, etc., is about the physical world. What you're talking about is soul realization that is then followed by connection to the Supreme Soul and then on to the goal of world transformation. Bapuji, with soul realization, all the karmas accumulated during your numerous incarnations that are stored in your subtle bodies, causal and supracausal bodies, will be erased. When the karmas are wiped out of your causal supracausal bodies, your physical body will gradually transform into a light body. You will transform from the form to the formless. Your subtle body will be made up of supreme elements. After that, you can multiply yourself into 1,000 forms and help assist many souls towards liberation, mukti and jivan mukti. Even if one soul attains this, the world will be transformed. And if 50 or 100 awaken, we'll be able to change the universe or even the multiverse. Our goal is to change the multiverse. Therefore, receive the knowledge, receive this knowledge of the infinite accordingly. My reason to provide clarity on the third eye is because there is a lot of confusion on this topic, but they don't know that the third eye is the soul itself. From the scriptures, the Vedas and the Puranas that I've studied, other than Lord Shiva, no one has a third eye. Even through some of the sages meditated for many years, the only level they could go to was the realm of Lord Brahma or Lord Vishnu. To achieve liberation, these sages used to meditate for many ages but wouldn't achieve it. They would always get stuck in the realm of Lord Brahma, which is the realm of super illusion or Mahamaya, and they stop beyond that in the realm of Lord Vishnu, which is the realm of supreme elements and illusion. Hence, they were never able to reach the supreme abode. So becoming desireless, don't have any desires except for spreading the vibrations of supreme peace for world transformation. You have a rare chance to make your fortune future in the infinite abode. And how can we make your fortune? What is the difference between fortune and the fortune of the infinite abode? Your fortune will be made when you receive the knowledge of the infinite, realize and recognize the Almighty Authority, and participate in the mission of world transformation. The ones that listen to the knowledge and like it but haven't done anything to help with the transformation will not make a place in Behad. If you didn't help at all with the process, then your fortune will not be made. You will not become a soul of the infinite. You will not be able to reach the supreme abode. What are the attributes of an infinite soul? They will immerse themselves in the knowledge of the infinite. They will remain in soul consciousness, spread the vibrations of supreme peace and assist in world transformation process. They will know the Almighty Authority in his human form, work with him, and only by their actions towards the cause can we determine their fortune. Without any action, can we achieve any level of transformation? What is our slogan? With everyone's assistance, we achieve the transformation of the infinite realm, Behad. With self-transformation, you can assist in world transformation. Share knowledge with others. Everyone should share knowledge, as it is considered one of the noblest of actions. Give knowledge and engage yourself in self-transformation. I won't go into further detail on how self-transformation will assist in world transformation. There are many videos on this subject. Anant, Bapuji, you've put out a great video series titled Atmaswarup that was recorded the other day. It has parts 1, 2 and 3 and it explains how vibrations can change the entire multiverse. I will present the link for it in the description box below this video. I request all viewers to watch the playlist titled Unspoken Truth by Bapuji. To bring forth the knowledge and to experience whether it is true or not, you will have to listen and understand Bapuji's knowledge. That's how you will know whether you are on the right track or not. People do the white light meditation technique and they think that that is what meditation is. But what Bapuji has said is that there are 18 different types of yogas, and the yoga that Bapuji is teaching is very unique and different. We have a playlist for meditation that everyone can check out. Watch the Atmaswarup videos as well, and you will receive new illumination. Would you like to add anything else, Bapuji? Bapuji, I will just say this. Stay in the soul consciousness state and take power from the divine and transform yourself. Also, assist in the world transformation process and stay connected with us. Anant, I'll request everyone who wishes to join to note my email address in the description box. Send me an email and let me know details of how long you've been listening to Bapuji's knowledge and what your experiences are. This will help us to assist you better. Thank you very much, Bapuji. Param Shanti.